Life is great and beautiful. Life is to be nurtured and not tampered with. It all started with infections, mean mosquitoes drinking and draining. First calm, cool, then it became cruel with numbers growing rapidly like the beans without soil. With great force, it came to claim our own. It became our burden in where there was no one to hold. With our tears, we carry million cases of the infection. With greater tears, we bury thousands every year. With greater force and fury, we unmask her. She's no other but called Malaria. But with a greater voice, with a greater force, he stands out, firing forward for the defeat of Malaria. Out for Nigeria and Africa at large. With a greater voice, he screams no. He's no other one but Prince Nwoko. A greater voice here, a man of valor, leaving family, friends and foes behind, leaving the comfort and delectable meals of home, not out of lack of love, but out of greater love for humanity, into the space void of love itself, to create awareness against the deadly disease malaria in Nigeria and the continent of Africa. He journeyed into the white desert to fight the numbers. In the white desert, there is no life, no life to live, no day to dance into, no night to give sound sweet sleep. They ask us, how far are we willing to be heard? We say, as far as the South Pole is from where we're standing. Make no mistake, no ordinary man would journey this far, far deep into the hellish cold to make a bold statement. The ice, which dates back to millions of years ago, where dinosaurs roamed the earth. With a greater voice of change, in which we should pursue and cherish. With a greater voice of hope, in which we should hold. From Abuja, Nigeria, to Cape Town, South Africa, with a great force he kept moving. It's been rough and tough, but now it's enough. Urged on, he took the flight of 8 hours on Witchaway Base with other explorers. 8 meaning creation and new beginnings. It's a new beginning for Nigeria. With a greater cold in a place void of trees, animals, life. In a place void of day and night, but vivid lights and migrated penguins. In a frigid land, he gave Nigeria and the continent of Africa a voice. He makes history as the first black African to visit Antarctica with so much grace like the giants we are. The Nigerian flag was mounted on the South Pole, making the 13th country to hoist the flag. The change begins now. With a greater voice, Prince Nwoko announced to the world, Africa is ready to solve the malaria problem. Putting Africa on the global map, he rises to eradicate malaria through the Prince Nwoko Foundation. In a dark room, we bury malaria. To be dead and completely dusted from Nigeria. To be washed and completely wiped from Africa. We adorn him with great respect as he arrives. Like an eagle who had conquered its adversaries. Like a lion which has paved way for its young cubs. Indeed, the eradication project has begun. Yet again I say, with a greater voice and support of the people, with a greater force and support of the appropriate authorities and environmental experts, we bury malaria beneath the earth. For one day we will cheer like the child with no worries. With a great voice we will laugh, laughing loud when we asked, when last did you have malaria? Fulfilling in our thoughts, we will remember the white deserts. Remember Prince Nwoko, a great man who eradicated malaria in Africa.